Welcome to Dr. Tates, Adventures in Good Health, hosted by Dr. Stephen Tates. Join us as we explore various health modalities made available to us as health consumers today. How do we determine which program is right for us? Diet, exercise, vitamins, herbs, acupuncture, massage therapy, and meditation are all possibilities to help create a better balance in our lives. Join us as we journey through a jungle of health choices made available today. Join Dr. Tates in Doc's Herbal Corner as we explore the myths and truths of the herbal kingdom.
Greetings and welcome to Doc's Herbal Corner. I am your host, Dr. Stephen Tates. Join me as we explore the science and mysteries of the herbal kingdom. You will learn about properties, functions, and physical responses plants and herbs can and will have on our body. But before we get started with our lesson plan for today, I want to test your basic knowledge on plants and herbs. So grab your pen or pencil and let's get started. Our question for today is on vinegar of the four thieves. Is vinegar of the four thieves A, a blood cleanser, B, an antibiotic, or C, a laxative? At the end of this segment, we will give you the answer. Today's lesson is on vinegar of the four thieves, one of my personal favorites. But before I explain to you what vinegar of four thieves is good for, I wanted to give you a little bit of a history of vinegar of the four thieves. Vinegar of the four thieves is a name of an herbal formula that goes back at least to the mid-1400s. What you want to do is picture a period in time where disease, famine, plagues was predominant. People were dying by the millions. Today they would call it a pandemic. They just called it simply death. Millions and millions of people across Europe died. The average lifespan was like 18, 19 years of age. Diseases were very common. And what would happen is that a plague would start in one area of the country and it rapidly spread throughout their country. So from like 900 AD to about the 1600s, diseases, plagues, and wars were very common. Now, I want to take you to a period around mid-1400s in and around Paris, France. Now, think about the worst condition you can imagine. We're talking about a condition so bad that if I picked up these glasses and I was ill with a disease and put them back down, and you came 3 weeks later and grabbed these same glasses, you would get ill with the same disease that I had. That's how much this would travel from one person to another. It would travel not just from person to person, but from solid object to a person. So we're talking about one of the worst conditions. Now, during this time, whole cities were quarantined. And with a quarantine, most of the property, your gold, jewelry, diamonds property, were generally left with the people who were ill because people didn't want to get sick. When the quarantine was lifted, what ended up happening is that they would go back into this quarantine area and they were amazed. All the valuables were stolen. We're talking about all the diamonds, all the gold, all the silver, anything of value had disappeared. And this was very strange. People said, now, who would steal this knowing that they would die from the plague? This went on for about 20 to 25 years. Finally, four of them got caught, just the four thieves part of it. They went in front of a panel of judges in Paris. Remember, the history showed that long panel judges wearing the white wigs. In those days, the only verdict they knew was death. Now, how they were going to kill you, was the only thing they would, you know, you had to be concerned about. Were they going to torture you slowly, burn you at a stake, stone you to death? It really depended on their mood. But the church records of that day, which are the only records that were intact, showed that these four thieves looked very strange. Thing is that they looked healthy. Skin was clear, no fungus, no open sores, no whooping cough, full head of hair, nails weren't dark, fungus and parasites weren't growing out of open sores. Basically, they were healthy. This confused the church and the local government. How you going and stealing stuff from people who are dying, digging up graves and stealing the valuables, and you weren't ill. So negotiations went on. These negotiations went on with these four thieves, I understand, for weeks. I'm sure torture was involved in that, because basically they wanted to get the formula of what they were doing to stay healthy. So what ended up happening is that they were sentenced to be burnt at the stake. The church made a deal with them. You give up the formula, and we will commute your sentence. So the formula was given up. It was a vinegar-based formula, thus the name Vinegar of the Four Thieves. They gave up this formula to save their life. Now, this is a formula that is a sun-extracted formula that has very unique herbs to it. Some of these unique herbs are very familiar to you. You're talking about, of course, garlic. Garlic is one of the primary herbs. Garlic is used because garlic is a natural antibiotic, organic form of penicillin, an antifungal, antiviral, antiparasitic. So it helped in protecting and dealing with some of the worst viruses that existed. But garlic was just the beginning or the tip of the iceberg. We had other herbs. Another herb that was involved was wormwood. This is wormwood. This is what wormwood looks like. Wormwood is also an antibiotic, or an organic form of penicillin, an antifungal, an antibacteria, an antiviral. So we have garlic and we have wormwood. But then there was another ingredient. The other ingredient was lavender. Yes, lavender. Same lavender that you would use in your bath oils and in scents and in aromatherapy. Now, why lavender? Well, lavender, like wormwood and garlic, guess what? That's right. It's a natural antibiotic, organic form of penicillin, an antiparasitic, an antifungal, an antiseptic. So now we have garlic, we have wormwood, we have lavender. Now, what is our next herb? Guess what? Our next herb is rosemary. Yes, rosemary. Same herb you would use in scents. This is rosemary. Now, what are the properties of rosemary? Guess what? Rosemary is, that's right, an antibiotic, an organic form of penicillin, an antifungal, an antiviral, an antiseptic. See where I'm going with this theme? We also have peppermint. We have rue. So we're dealing with wormwood, lavender, rosemary, mint, rue, garlic, and they're all mixed in an apple cider vinegar mixture. And they sit in the sun, and they sit in the sun sometimes 2 to 3 weeks. This would depend on what season, summer, less time, winter, longer time. Sits in the sun, so the sun serves as the extractor. So these herbs were not heated, so all the properties were preserved in the solution. Then after all these herbs was mixed for an extended period of time, then they're drained out and garlic is added. Garlic is the last mixture to draw out all the properties of the garlic into the solution, which is apple cider vinegar. What happens is you've created a mixture that's called Vinegar of the Four Thieves that has all these herbs mixed together that will work for the worst conditions that exist in the world. Epidemic, pandemic, respiratory problems, makes no difference. And thus, we have Vinegar of the Four Thieves. Now, our question for today. Remember our question? It's on Vinegar of the Four Thieves. Is Vinegar of the Four Thieves A, blood cleanser, B, an antibiotic, or C, a laxative? If you put B, an antibiotic, congratulations, you were correct. And oh, by the way, those four thieves, they weren't burnt at the stake, they were hung. And I want to thank you for joining us at Doc's Herbal Corner. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.